Hello students, so welcome to my next online class. So this is the continuation video of the previous chapter, force and pressure. In the previous class we have solved the exercise questions, and as you know, numericals plays a vital role in physics. So today we are going to solve some numericals based upon this chapter, force and pressure, right? So in the board you can see I have noted down one question here. The breadth of an iron door is 2.4 meter. If the minimum torque required to open the door is 50 Newton meter, what is the minimum force required to open the door? You see, we know torque equals to force into distance. So this is the formula, right? Torque is given 50 Newton meter. That means Newton meter is the unit of moment of force or torque, and meter is the unit of distance. So first we have noted down, and what we have to find? We have to find force. So force equals to F equals to question mark. Now, we need to find here force, that means F will be torque by T. What is torque here? That is 50, and D we know 2.4, that is 50 into 10 will be going up, that is 24. Now when you cancel 2 5 ja, 2 12 ja, or 2 25 ja, 2 6 ja, that is 125 by 6. Now when you will divide this one, the answer you will be getting 20.8. Right, so this is our required answer. So the next question we have, question number 2, the amount of force to be applied on the spanner at a length of 0.25 meters from the bolt is 400 Newton. Find the torque. Find the torque to open a bolt. Right? So this is the question. Here in the question, what is given here? That is length of spanner. That is length is given. That means we will consider this one to be as we consider D, that is 0.25 m, and 400 Newton is given. 400 Newton, that is the force, and we need to find here torque. Right? We'll use the same formula, torque equals to F into D. So in place of F, we will substituting here 400, and in place of D, that is 25 by 100. If point will get removed, 100 will be coming down. So 2 zeros and 2 zeros got cancelled. 4 into 25, that is 100 Newton meter. This is our answer. So next question. So I will be giving some questions in your home task, as a home task also. So similar questions you will try to solve in your exercise book, okay? So the questions which I am solving in a board, that those questions also you need to write in your exercise book, as well as the other questions, okay, the homework questions also. Next question we move, question number 3. A force of 1000 Newton acts on an area of 0.050 meter square. Find the pressure in Pascal. Right? So this is our question. A force of 1000 Newton, that means in this question here, what is given? Force, that is 1000 Newton, will be known down here. of an area of 0.050, that is area is also given 0.050 meter square, and we need to find here pressure. So we know pressure equals to force per unit area. So in place of force, we will be substituting here 1000 in place of area 0.050, right? Or this can be rewritten as P equals to 1000 as it is into 1, 2, 3, that is 30 will be going up and in denominator we have 50, right? So 10 and 10 got cancelled, that is 520 joule, that is 20,000 Pascal, or this can be written as 2 into 10 to the power 4 Pascal, right? So this is our required answer. Or sometimes you can write here 20 kPa also, meaning is same 20,000, or this can be written as 20 into 10 to the power 3 Pascal, or 20, this one is kilo, kPa. So in any form you can leave your answer. Next question we have, calculate the area of a body which experiences a pressure of 60 kPa by a force of 12,000 Newton. Right? So we need to calculate here area now. So we have to find here area. What is given? Pressure is given here, that is 60 kPa, that means 60 into 10 to the power 3 Pascal by a force of 12,000 Newton. So pressure equals to force per unit area. So in place of force, we'll be writing 12,000, and in place of area, we'll be writing. So area we need to find here. So you see the formula will get changed, that is area equals to F by P, right? So in place of P here, F, in place of P we'll substituting the P value, 60 into 10 to the power 3, right? So 10 and 10 got cancelled, so 6 200s are, so you see 200 by 3 zeros are there. So out of 3 zeros, 2 0 and 2 0 got cancelled, so answer is 0.2. So 1 0 is left, so after 1 digit, 0.2, that is meter square. Okay, so this is our required answer. So next question we have, question number 8. A block of weight 100 Newton and dimension 50 cm into 30 cm into 10 cm raised on a table in 3 different positions. With its base point number A 50 cm into 30 cm, point number B 30 cm into 10 cm, and point number C 50 cm into 10 cm. Calculate the pressure exerted in each case. Okay, so you see this is the question. Now what is said here? Let us consider this is the block, right? So when this is the block, you see first position is this one. In this position, how much pressure it is exerting in the ground, right? Now another position will be this one. At this position, how much pressure is exerted at the ground? And you see this length, so this length and this breadth more or less same, but in this case this dimension says that block is not same here, that means length is different, this is length, this is breadth and this is height. So first position was this one, second position is this one, and third position is otherwise this one, right? In terms of different length, the dimensions are given, that is length into breadth ways, right? So in which case it is exerting how much pressure? So that one we need to calculate. So there will be three answers for point number A, point number B, and point number C. So the question is misprint here. So a block of weight, it should be 10 newton, right? Now we'll find first case, that is case 1, solution here. Case 1, force is 10 newton and area will be taking this one, that is 50 centimeter into 30 centimeter. So first we'll calculate this one, 5 3 is 15, or 51 centimeter equals to 1 by 100 meter, and 1 centimeter equals to 1 by 100 meter. That means 5 3 is 15, 2 zeros in numerator, that is here, and 4 zeros in denominator. So 2 zeros and 2 zeros got cancelled, 0.15 meter square, right? So centimeter we need to convert to meter square. Now we know area, we know force. So first pressure, that is P1 equals to F by A here, or better you can write here F1 A1. F1 by A1. F1 we have 10 divided by 0.15, right? So 10 into 100 divided by 15. So more or less you will be getting answer here 1000 divided by 15, that is 66.67. That is 66.67 Pascal, right? So the calculation, for just showing you the calculation, I have used here calculator, but you will be solving manually, right? Because your calculator is not allowed. Be careful. So similarly, you will be finding for P2 also. So in the P2 case, we will be considering here, we need to find P2 here. So F2 and F1 is same. Let us consider it F only. F is here how much? 10, and or initially I have taken here F1. So F1 is 10, and area to will get changed, that is 30 into 10, that is 300 centimeter square. Now 300 centimeter square, if you need to change to meter square, we have to divide by 4 zeros, that is meter square. So 2 zero and 2 zero got cancelled, that is 0.03. That is area we know. Now you will find pressure by using this formula, F by A, right? So likewise, you will be solving for third case also. So you will be getting three answers. So this will be your required answer. The whole answer is incorrect. Whatever answer you get here, that will be your correct answer. Just I will give you the answer. This answer is correct, 66.67, and second answer 333.33 Pascal, and last one you will be getting here 200 Pascal, right? And first answer was 66.67 Pascal. So when you will solve, you will just tally with these answers. So next question I will be explaining from the book itself. You see question number 9. If a girl is wearing a pointed heel which has the area of cross section 2 cm square, and if her mass is 650 newton, find out the pressure exerted by her on the floor. Remember to calculate for both legs. So you see, first what is given? Area is given. So area of 1 foot is given, that means 1 pointed heel is given, so you need to multiply by 2, and it is given in centimeter, so you need to convert to meter square, like previous question, right? Force is given 650 newton, so you will calculate the pressure, that is P equals to F by A. Answer is 1625 kilopascal. Last question, that is question number 10, that is very easy. You see, just we need to apply the formula. An office safe has a weight of 800 newton. If the area of base is 1.25 meter square, what is the pressure on the floor of the office? That means we know we have to calculate here pressure, that is P equals to F by A. F is given 800 newton divided by A, that is 1.25. So when you remove the point, 100 will be going up,
therefore 800 into 100 divided by 125. Now you will cancel, you will get the answer, right? Answer is 640 PA. So these numericals I will be giving in your WhatsApp group also, so you need to note down in your exercise book. Practice very hard. Very soon there will be a unit test followed by exams, right? And these marks will be carried forward in your annual exam. So be serious and take the online classes seriously. Thank you.